Hey guys, today we're rebuilding my favorite derailleur of all time, the DRXD M739.
It does apply to both the 737 and the 739. They're pretty much the same thing, except for like a few small changes.
And the only tools we need are an Allen set, some pliers, a pick, and a screwdriver. Now the easy part is done and time to service the springs. For the B spring, all you need to do is find that little pinch bolt and unscrew it with a 2 millimeter Allen wrench. There you go. Now it springs out. Should have popped that seal off too. And for the P spring, just go ahead and pop off this clip. Now you want to pull the little tab towards you and the P-spring will spring out. Just like that. Alright, and then go ahead and slide out the bolt. Alright, now this thing is all taken apart. And now it's time to clean. For this, I like to use some cleaner or degreaser. Just make sure if you're using something harsh like brake cleaner, stay away from the plastic parts. And if your derailleur is rusty, make sure to clean it off first before using metal rescue or vapor rust. And in my case, I'm using this ultrasonic cleaner. And all I'm using is water and some dish soap. Alright, now with everything cleaned down and ready to go, I also gave some of the chrome parts a wax with some of this quick glow. And I'm going to do some polishing on the aluminum parallelogram with some of this AutoSol. Alright, here it is, all polished down. It's alright, could be better, but we'll go with it. And now time for assembly, and another thing you're going to need is grease. Alright, first start off by greasing up the inside of the pinnacle. Make sure you get all the little sides greased up. And then get your spring out. One side has a recession that goes in a little bit, and one side is completely flush, as you can see. You want a side with the recession to stick up. So go ahead, find the little hole, put in your spring. All right, you also have two of these plastic seals. They're pretty similar. And you want to use this thinner one for the pinnacle right here, and the thicker one we're going to use on the binnacle. So get that seal. Thinner one and put it on and go ahead and slide in your bolt. You want to do it with a little bit of a rotating motion so the grease spreads evenly. Now put on your chrome retaining ring, and I highly recommend taking out the B limit screw bolt because this is one of the hardest pinnacles to put back together and you need some leverage. All right, now comes the hardest part of the build. You want to get this tab all the way around behind here, and I like to use a pair of pliers just to kind of rotate it up. You want to rotate it higher, and then you want to push it down at the end. All right, so sadly I couldn't film that because it's in a really hard position. I needed to bring it closer to me. So now get your clip when the tab is in place and slide it on. All right, same thing for the B spring. You want to grease up the inside. Make sure you get all the surfaces, and now here we have two little holes, and you can put the spring in one of them, and you want to put this little thinner side into one of the holes. All right, so this one on the one on the right is the looser one, and the one on the left is the tighter one, and we're gonna go with the tighter one. And don't worry about those two holes on the top. I'm not sure what they're for, but yeah. All right, so put your little seal on, get it ready to go, and then you also want this pin ready, and you want a 2 mil ready. So right when you put it in, you're going to screw in the pinch bolt. All right, so you want to line up this little end with the hole in there. And then after that, screw in the pinch bolt. All right, so once you feel that it goes all the way down, now your derailleur looks like this, and you want to rotate it around this direction Then you want to push it down, and then now you want to screw in the 2mm pinch bolt. All right, make sure the cage is all the way down, then grease it up a little bit and screw it in. Make sure it's all the way in. Don't have to cinch it down too much, and you're good to go. Look at that, nice and smooth. All right, now time for the pulleys. For the ceramic pulley, you can use normal grease, you can use ceramic grease. I like to use a little bit of oil, as you can see that yellow stuff on there, and grab your ceramic bushing and put it on. And you can put some more oil in there or grease on the inside of that one too. Put a little bit of oil on there, then make sure you put the seals on, make sure they face outwards so they actually catch the dirt like this. Then go ahead, put the seals on and screw on the bolt. All right, now just put the seals on and slide the pulley onto the bolt. And for the guide pulley, you want to grease up this inside part with some actual grease. Remember, you just want a little bit on the inside of the big pulley, and you want a little bit on the inside of the steel bushing. All right, make sure you tighten down the pulley bolts, put on the barrel adjuster and the clamp bolt, and then you have yourself a fully rebuilt derailleur. Keith Bontrager once said, cheap, light, and strong, pick two. Well, I'm sorry, Keith, but I have to pick all three. 739 is super reliable, quite light at only 247 grams, and it only costed me $20 in dirty condition. So remember guys, if you have an old derailleur, don't replace it, just rebuild it. Thanks to anyone who subbed to the channel, subscribe for more, and I'll see you in the next one.